My name is Patrick, Patrick Bitaturi. Today I'm talking to young people, those who have not yet made the decision on which career path to go to. I recall, it was 15 years ago, I went to different schools talking to young people on career days to give them some guidance on what course to take. And I remember going to a school and on a Friday, I think, and they had told me that on Monday they had had a lawyer there, on Tuesday they had a doctor, on Wednesday they had an engineer, on Wednesday on Thursday they had some other profession, and the last day for career guidance was Friday, and so I'd been invited to talk a bit about business. And I found that nearly all the intelligent students had already made up their mind, and the very brainy ones, if you are good in sciences, then you're going to be either an engineer or a doctor. It depends if you like the biology or you did maths. And that was endorsed by their teachers and also by the parents. And then if you're good in arts, you're going to be a lawyer or a politician. And because you had the ability or the oratory ability to speak and deliver speeches and debate. And then others who cared about the environment wanted to do sociology and different courses. And then if everything else failed, only then would you look at or consider doing business. To me, I felt belittled because business is so important. We need to get more people who are talented, who are intelligent doing business. Not those who have failed in everything else are the ones who are going to go into business. And if you get somebody who's really smart and he gets into business, he will do or she will do well. They will climb that ladder and succeed and create many jobs and employ many engineers and many lawyers and many doctors, build hospitals, because they understand business. Business is at the heart of the economy. And when they talk of the private sector, the people leading the private sector, the captains of industry, are business people. In our society, Uganda, a good amount of the contribution from collected by URA is from the Asian community. Why? Because they understand business. It's inbuilt in them. Slowly, steadily, Ugandans are also entering that space of manufacturing, of big trading, big houses. But we are still very few in that space. I need to urge Ugandan parents, because I think it's the parents largely at fault. When your child is brilliant, yes, we need doctors, we need engineers, but not all of them should go down that career. Because I don't see an engineer earning more than 30, 40 million shillings per month. And that's $10,000. Globally, that's a slow amount of money. Maybe a doctor in the US will probably earn $50,000 a month, but if it's a cardiologist or somebody like that. But it's very possible for a Ugandan business to earn $50,000 a month and pay its taxes and contribute to the economy. Many industrialists earn a lot more than that per month. So if it's about money, then business is probably the best way to go. If it's about having a big social impact, also business is the way to go. Business is not as noble as being a teacher or being a doctor or being a nurse. Yes, it's not as noble. But you can employ many nurses and teachers and doctors. You can build hospitals. You can have big social impact on your community where you come from if you want to make a difference in people's lives by entering business. And the earlier you get into it and study it and understand it, the ins and outs of it, the intricacies of business, the better. So I urge many people to look at entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is a fast-growing area that people have got to embrace, because the entrepreneurs are the ones who change the society. They create opportunities. Because if we have all these nurses looking for jobs and they're all now being exported because there aren't enough hospitals here, yet we need them. So we need to create the opportunities. Entrepreneurs see opportunities and make them a reality. There's a gap in the market. How do I make it a reality? Whether it's in the hotel industry, then you create jobs. Whether it is in the catering industry, you create jobs. In things that you require by building schools, building universities, making them private schools that can compete with government institutions. We are coming from a very low base, so we've got a lot of work to do in this space of entrepreneurship. And I really like to call upon the young, talented people to give it a second look. Look more closely at entrepreneurship. It's a very enriching, enlivening experience. It's a good career path to go down. You feel very satisfied. When you deliver a service, people pay for it, you become wealthy in the process, because you are helping so many people. Now, when you make 100,000 shillings, that's your money. When you make 10 million shillings also, that's probably your money. And you want to see how you spend it. When you start making over 100 million shillings per year, then you've got a bit more of a responsibility. Now, when you're in the realms of a billion shillings and above, then you've got a responsibility to the society because they have trusted you with their resources. Then you have to, a responsibility to do more, whether it's by CSR, whether you're making contributions to the church, to the hospitals, you have a bigger responsibility to help the weaker in your society. And that's why they've trusted you. They are buying goods from you. You've got this responsibility. That's why people who have a lot of money have got a bigger responsibility to society. At least that's how I feel. If you make a lot of money and you're just selfish and your money is yours and you're going to be a Scrooge, good luck to you. But you're not going to live a life of purpose, a life of meaning. So I encourage young people to think about entrepreneurship, building solid businesses, and impacting people's lives. I hope this helps you.